Any idea how it's going in?
I'm sure Jax is having second thoughts about bringing Brenda in right now.
Brenda, she's testifying right now.
Jax is counting on Brenda to paint me as a dangerous animal. That way he can get custody of Jocelyn and cause problems between us. Okay, let me tell you something about Brenda. She may have doubts about me and my life, mm-hmm. When it comes down to it, she will come through.
It may not matter what Brenda says in there. The danger is real.
I want to be sure I've understood. Someone opened fire on you and your young son last night outside your husband's home.
Yes.
How many shots were fired?
I don't even know. It happened really fast, and no one was hurt, and we were in a bulletproof car, so it wasn't that big of an event, actually.
Well, be that as it may, I'd like to see the police report.
All right, now the same. Get pregnant. I'm sure it's a hot topic. How dangerous our business is, but you got to put that aside. Because Carly's in trouble.
No, right? I know that. I'm just being realistic about what Carly's up against, that's all.
A manipulative jerk who's trying to punish Carly by taking her daughter away. You think Jack should...
What? Come on, Sonny. No, of course not.
Oh, he doesn't care who he inflicts damage on. All he wants to do is win, and he wants to take Jocelyn, and he wants more than that, if you know what I'm talking about.
I know you think that Jack's...
No, look, I don't think I know. He's been working on Brenda's fears ever since he found out her child was alive. Okay, this is his chance to grab it all. And you know what he's going to wind up with? Nothing.
I'm just saying Jax doesn't need Brenda to make the case that our lives aren't safe.
Okay, look, Jax is counting on Brenda to break down and start talking about how dangerous I am, but he's miscalculated. Because she's not going to do that. And I'll tell you something else. There's no police record about the shooting last night, so the judge doesn't have to know anything, okay? So basically, Jax's plan is gonna backfire.
I've told you everything about the accident and exactly how it happened, so.
You and your son were shot at, yet you maintain you weren't in danger.
No, I don't maintain that. That's the truth.
Then that will be corroborated by the statement you gave to the police and any forensic evidence collected at the scene.
I don't think you understand exactly what I'm saying to you. There was an accident that happened on our property. And because no one was hurt, apparently we didn't report it to the police. So.
You may not be aware, but that opens the door to all kinds of charges. For the moment, however, we will focus on this custody hearing. At issue is the danger your husband poses to Jocelyn Jax.
My husband is the most loving man that I have ever known, and he is fiercely protective. And he puts his family, and especially his children, first. He would give his life for his children. So, in terms of this hearing, my husband isn't married to Carly Jax. My husband is married to me. So he doesn't spend enough time with Carly to pose any kind of danger to Jocelyn.
So how'd it go?
Well, he told me I was under oath, and we started talking, we talked
talking about... Talking about what?
We talked about last night, and I told him, you know, that we were, Alec and I were in the car and that somebody shot at the car. I told him no one was hurt. And I told him that, you know, Sonny's a good man. And that he doesn't spend enough time with Jocelyn to put her in any danger.
So think about how you would feel if someone was trying to take away Alec because of Sonny, just like Jax is trying to take away Jocelyn.
I don't have to think about how that would make me feel. I know how that would make me feel. And I have no idea what this judge already knows, so I'm not going to lie to the judge.
The shooting was never reported to the police. No witnesses, nobody had to know.
Okay, well, you know what? I told the truth.
Was it about the truth? Really? Or were you just trying to get back at Carly?
Has Mrs. Jax ever brought her daughter Jocelyn to your home?
Once or twice. She didn't come regularly.
And how would you characterize your relationship with your ex-wife?
We're on good terms. We I think we're good parents to both of our sons.
Is it true that Mrs. Jax brought Jocelyn to court when you were being tried for murder?
Yeah, it's true.
Have children been harmed as a direct result of your actions, Mr. Krenthos?
My kid's safety is the number one priority.
That's not what I asked.
I would never harm any of my children.
Is it true there was a shooting at your property last night? That your wife and her son were inside a limousine that was being strafed with bullets?
Okay, yeah. None of them were hurt.
Have any of your children ever been shot? Mr. Krenthos, I asked you...
Stop! I'm sorry. But can we please just stop this? And can we not make Sonny relive the shooting of our son Michael or bring in a whole bunch of witnesses that is going to make both of us relive the worst time of our lives?
My concern isn't your level of discomfort, Mrs. Jax. It's the welfare of your daughter.
What's yours, Jax? Clearly not Jocelyn.
I'll ask the questions, Mr. Krenthos.
She loves her kids. She's protective. Why are we even talking about this right now?
Mr. Krenthos, your purpose in being here is to shed light.
Please just wait. I'll be honest, okay? I will stipulate that horrible, awful things have happened. But Jax, you knew all that when you married me. You knew all that when you chose to conceive a child with me. Now, admit I'm not perfect, okay? I'm not, but I don't want full custody. I don't want to take Jocelyn away from Jax. I want to share custody with Jax. And I promise you that when I have Jocelyn, I will do everything in my power to keep her safe.
Your Honor, I can provide additional evidence to support what's clearly obvious. Carly's life is surrounded by violence, and she has no intention of cutting her ties with her ex-husband, Sonny Krenthos.
We share two children, Jax.
That's what I'm trying to protect Jocelyn from.
Stop talking, all of you. I've heard enough to make my evaluation.
You did the right thing by stopping it before it went any further.
Nothing you have done is for Jocelyn, okay? Every decision you're making is going to destroy her in the end.
Well, I'm not surprised you feel that way.
Yeah.
I know Brenda talked about the shooting last night.
She was under oath. She must have felt like she didn't have a choice.
The details couldn't have come out of her mouth fast enough.
That's the least of our damage, because the judge must have done his homework. He going on and on about how violence surrounds me, that I'm a danger to people, verse by verse, if it wasn't for Carly stopping him. I'm sorry.
I apologize. The damage was done before you and Brenda walked in the room. That mediator had it out for me. I mean, she was crucifying me, and there's no way in hell she could have had enough information to take Jax's side from that one meeting.
Did not help that I charged into Jax's office. I didn't know who the woman was, and I went off on Jax.
It doesn't matter. That mediator had already made up her mind. You're right. Jax paid that bitch off. Hey.
Hey. You okay? What you doing here?
Well, what's going on with the custody hearing? I just wanted to check.
Everything's, going okay, I guess. The judge is just making a ruling.
What do you mean, it's over?
Yeah, he said he heard enough, so.
Wow. Well, Sonny and I are going to be, having a huge argument over my testimony, I'm sure.
Yeah, I'm sure. I didn't know that you were shot at last night.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that you're bracing yourself to take the blame for not keeping quiet, right?
I guess so. I mean, apparently no one filed a police report, so everyone thought that the judge didn't need to know.
Right, but you told the truth.
Yeah, it's a concept, right?
Yeah, that Sonny is dangerous. I'm sure he's gonna try to blame me now for manipulating you into talking. You must be terrified.
Now, I was terrified yesterday, but, you know, I told the judge the truth. You know, no one was hurt. I mean, Sonny tells me that we were never really in any danger at all, so.
Yeah, men were shooting at you and your son with guns.
Yeah, but the car was bulletproof, and they did aim below the windows.
Come on, listen to yourself.
I know.
Right? I mean, I don't care how Sonny tries to dress it up. You and your kid could have been killed.
I should have realized how far Jax would go to win. While I'm sitting here trying to compromise, he's sharpening his knife so he can stick it in my back.
You can't blame yourself for what happened in that
The place. Judge only heard half the story, okay? He didn't hear how much Sonny and I love our kids. He only heard the bad, and I had to stop it. We didn't need to hear that.
This is important. When were you notified who the mediator was going to
be? 2 weeks ago.
How many times did you meet with this Grace?
Just the once.
One time, and she based her opinion on that?
She said she was reviewing the various depositions.
Okay, put your feelings aside. Do you really believe that she genuinely thought Jocelyn was better off with Jax?
She never came to see Jocelyn once. She had no idea about our living environment. She never had one conversation with Michael, but she said he was an unstable felon. There is no way that she can make an objective decision to say that Jocelyn was better off with Jax.
Take Hardy home, will
you? Oh, wait a second. This is my daughter, Sonny. If you're going to do something, I want to know about it and I want to help.
You got to trust me. I'm going to make this right. Thank you. Hey, no, look, I'm so happy that you got me this information so quick. No, yeah, I'll let you know. Thank you. Grace, hi, glad I ran into you. Sonny Corinthos.
Yes, I know who you are.
Well, you know, we met, it was like on the wrong foot, and I thought that maybe I can make it up to you.
Look, I'm afraid I really don't have time. I'm on my way to a meeting. I have nothing to say to you, Mr. Corinthos.
You are a busy woman.
Yes.
You're busy separating a child from her mother.
Mr. Corinthos.
Busy cashing Jax's checks.
I had no idea when you were called as a witness that you'd been shot at. I'm sorry. But I'm still grateful that you told the truth.
Yeah.
Well, with your testimony, I think I can win. I'll get full custody of Jocelyn and she'll be safe.
Look, I want you to remember something. Well, first I want you to know that I do think that Carly's unstable. And I don't think she's the greatest mother in the world. But she is Jocelyn's mother. You know, I lived my whole life without a mom. And I feel unlovable to this day because of that, so just... You know?
I'm not gonna take Jocelyn from her mother. That's not the goal here. My goal is just to get Jocelyn out of danger. You know? I really wish that I could do the same for you and your kid.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Now, if you don't move out of my way, I'm gonna call for help. And that's not gonna help your ex-wife's custody situation.
You may be smart about throwing a custody hearing, but you're not too smart about hiding your money. Next time you take a bribe, you should put it offshore, because I know you took $300,000 from Jax. And I'm thinking to myself, he's a millionaire. $300,000 for his daughter doesn't seem like a lot of money. You could have held out for more. Okay. Now, I could turn you in, right? You could lose your license, your career. You could even go to prison.
Okay. I needed the money. My life will be over. What do you want?
I want you to do exactly what I want you to do.